Trans Nzoia, about 100 years ago, that is in 1920s, was like any village in anywhere in Europe. Fantastic infrastructure, fantastic water systems. Call it. These things started deteriorating in the 70s and 80s and 90s. Of course, in the 60s, there was that momentum when Wazungus left. So the historical momentum kept some of these things alive. So our challenge today as the leaders of Trans Nzoia is to really see how can we reclaim that glory. Trans Nzoia then was producing most of the, actually I would say about 80% of all the maize produced in the country. Today we don't grow wheat as we speak, just because we don't have the necessary machinery. We used to be a leading dairy producer in the country. We used to feed Upland's bakery, the bacon factory with the pigs. But today, instead of advancing, we seem to be moving backwards. That has really created a lot of worry for us, and I believe this forum is going to help us retrace our steps. Where did we go wrong? Why are our youth wasted? Why is there rampant poverty? Not that the settlers moved away with our resources. Our land is still there. Our climate is still there. The labor which they were using is still there. What really happened? What went wrong? It is a question of attitude. And I think policymakers have to have a paradigm shift. Business of white collar jobs, I think we better put it aside and say no. If it is the wealth creation we are looking for, that's not the direction to go. The direction is in agriculture. And our youth must be at the forefront. They are no longer going to be spectators, but they must be at the center of moving our counties to the next level.
Tafiti Sera means research policy. And the objective really of Tafiti Sera is to do move research from where it is done, evidence that is available, and to bring that evidence to the table with the objective of trying to get consensus around particular policy issues and having those issues tackled based on evidence. But the idea there is to be able to highlight the different ways within which Utafiti Sera actually helps to bridge the evidence to policy gap. So the challenge for Trans Nzoia government, county government, is to create employment for the youth. And they tend to look at the best way to create employment for the youth. Then researchers come on the table and provide the evidence that is available. That evidence can be, you know, with synthesis of literature or evidence which has already been done, or through empirical research. And then a negotiated position is arrived at.
Youth, now can you come in? Organize yourselves. The youth organize, we tell them, organize yourselves. You have access to youth farm. Then you start buying maize when it's ready for marketing. You value add. You get maize meal. You get maize jam. You get what? All these things from what? From maize. At the end of the day, you can make money from the maize that we grow here in Trans Nzoia. Other things that we are encouraging, we try to encourage rabbit farming. We are saying that we have to get more money to the youth. We are telling our youth, please organize yourselves, register as a youth group, access what? Funds, either from the county kitty or the national kitty, and at the end of the day, make money.
Policies must be inclusive. So there is a need to have a system that includes all categories of youth. Some who dropped out of school at a very early age, those who are disabled, and those who may not be captured by the formal system. The other issue of professionalism came up very clearly, knowledge and skills. And we believe we could do that through apprenticeship program that links both formal and informal. It talks about policy issues. It talks about what the public can do, what the private can do. And it talks about bringing everybody together. Right now, the apprenticeship program that exists is about formal. University graduates or college graduates getting internships in industry or NGOs. We don't have an apprenticeship program like that one. That we need to shift away from just production by fueling capacity of young people to be creative. And we have learned here that young people are very creative, they are very energetic, and finding options for them to utilize that creativity. It has also come very clear, it came from the Director of Agriculture, the whole issue of intergenerational knowledge sharing and learning. That most of the informal knowledge is possessed by older people like yourself, and we have not transferred this knowledge to the young people. We say they are not interested, or they just go and drink. The attitude and the whole sense of belonging. Then there was a whole issue that whichever job you create, whether you are a laborer, whether you are a transporter, you must create value for that job. That means that if you are not satisfied with that job, find ways of how to make this job decent in terms of paying you and in terms of improving the standard of living. And if you cannot do it on your own, reach out to other people so that they can assist you. Then young people are contributing a lot, but are we recognizing them? Are we rewarding them? We must have a system that recognizes the contribution of young people so that it makes them feel that they belong and want to work hard. Young people take leadership. When we realize that young people are here to make a leadership role, all these experts in this room from counties have sat back so that we give you a chance to state what we can do.
Challenges we get is the packaging. Like for now, as we are packaging the crisps, so yeah, it's a challenge for us because we don't know what we're going to use to package our products with. So that's a challenge. Then water is also a challenge in advertising our products since to go uko mashinani.
We used a lot of money to produce the packages because in the packaging, that's where we have the backgrounds, the KVC satisfaction, the nutrient, the content inside, and all have won the waste because they are now under the cover. So that is another challenge we are facing. Another challenge we are having is about, you know, we are working with youths, and the youths have space or interest. So we have sometimes they can have what we call leadership language, because about youths, you know, a youth can become more than a youth than others. You know, there is that conflict of interest.
Some of the challenges that we have faced as a business include inadequate availability of specialized modern tools that we can actually use to enable us engage into mass production and mass fabrication of our system.
We've seen that there is a skills gap between what employers need and also what they need for them to get engaged in agriculture. There are many opportunities in agriculture and agro-processing, but these youths are not able to access the financing. One of the main reasons that has come out of the session we had this morning was on access. There are so many requirements for youth to be able to access the various funds which have been set up by the county government and also national government, but youth are not able to access these finances.
The youth, you have a big future in agriculture, because now even the way we do agriculture, we are actually now moving from the traditional way of doing things, and we are emphasizing on productivity, commercialization, and also increasing competitiveness in agriculture. And this will come by changing things the way we do them. This revolution will come through these young minds, these young people who are receptive to ideas and who are ready to change and move with the times. Because now we are even looking at agriculture from the climate smart perspective, because things are now changing.
From Busia County, we do commit that we are going to offer capacity, technical capacity building, basically training, which is our key mandate as extension officers. And this will be in addition to the three value chains that we are talking about here. This will also go along with other value chains. Three characteristics of the youth: one of them is that they are very energetic, secondly is that they are open-minded, and thirdly, these are risk takers. They will always like to try new things. With a lot of information around and the kind of gadgets that you have, like the smartphone, the tablets, and the computers, I believe the youth can really form a very good source of information app that will enable our farmers, and especially the youth, to be effectively engaged in agricultural production.
We have something we call village-based extension services that we have started in Kiambu, training the youth, especially on input, so that they can be able to advise the farmers. Because we realize that the people who are the agro vets, sometimes they don't even have the basic knowledge of agriculture or whatever they are doing. So we are going to train the youth, and then they will act as the ones who pass the messages, and they supply the input to the farmers.
I think as a county, we are going to invest much in processing and adding value so that our youth can benefit in the process of adding value. I take a bill in the parliament to support our youth about value addition.
We have this county forum to share lessons and experiences and policy messages for our own actions, but also messages for the county government and the national government. We also promise to deliver video clips and media coverage, including news articles or newspaper articles, to synthesize this information in terms of, first of all, procedures which we'll share with you, proceedings, to enrich the policy synthesis that is going on, because we have to incorporate your messages, and to enrich our policy brief so that we can take this to the next level, which is the national forum, which we are likely to hold in April or early May.